Hi guys, welcome back. This is Matt Chat, episode 325, featuring a review of the game Risen, a computer role-playing game by Piranha Bytes, the developers of the Gothic series. Now this is a really fun, if difficult, and challenging action-oriented role-playing game, but I think it's got a lot going for it, and I think you will too. Now if you want to pick up a copy for yourself, you can get it at Steam or GOG, and the links for that will be in the show notes. Anyway, we've got a lot to cover here, so without further ado, here is Risen. And here we go, folks, with a game called Risen by Piranha Bytes. Same guys that did the Gothic series, at least the first couple Gothics. They got into some kind of trouble, or their publisher got into some kind of trouble of a financial sort. And they ended up, Piranha Bytes ended up just abandoning that Gothic series, as far as I can tell, and launching this new franchise called Risen. So the short of it is, if you're familiar with the Gothic series, you should feel right at home with this game, at least I did. Alright, well, let's get the party started and see what we think about this Risen.
For longer than humanity remembers, the gods ruled. Humanity served as slaves, but life never remains in balance. Power passed to man, and man banished the gods from the world.
Richard Dawkins must be in charge of this place.
But something was released. Something older than man has risen.
Yeah, and it's starting to have a bit of an H.P. Lovecraft vibe to it. A Call of Cthulhu element there. Loving that. Huge fan of Lovecraft.
Given their freedom, humanity must fight for survival. Some cling to safety, others fight. It is a time where a man's choices define him.
So what would you guess? Good guy or bad guy? Good guy, bad guy. It's the guy with red flame shooting out of his arm. Probably don't want to piss him off. And he bravely dissipated into thin air. Oh boy. Surf's up. You guys waxed your boards. And that's the end of the game. I'll see you next time with Risen 2, and remember, always wear a life preserver. I wonder how many people actually stopped the video. I guess we'll never know. Well, as you can tell, we survived that shipwreck just fine.
Where am I?
We're on a mysterious island looking for Captain Nemo. Apparently his hideout is here somewhere. We'll find a submarine called the Nautilus. But I'm getting way ahead of ourselves here. Ah, Grog! Grog, Grog, Grog! Live me, Grog!
They didn't make it.
Need some drowned people.
She's
here.
Still breathing.
Ah, the lady survived.
Are you
midriff
okay?
Intact?
Yeah. Yeah. But I think I drank half the ocean.
Have some Grog!
Do you remember much about what happened?
Just that strange man from the Inquisition. And the storm. He sailed us straight into it. Then he vanished. The ship must have capsized and we got washed ashore.
Looks like the poor devils over there weren't as lucky as us.
Any idea where we are?
Well, this talk about Inquisition makes me think we're in a Dragon Age game.
No. Maybe it's another island.
We should get off this beach. This wreckage could draw looters and they don't like survivors. We're going to need a weapon. Do you think you could have a look around? See if the tide washed up something we can use? A club, a branch. Anything is better than nothing, right? I'll stay here and keep an eye out for other survivors.
Oh, that'll be useful. Oh, thank you, Sarah. What would we do without you? She can't even be bothered to reach down and pick up a gold coin right at her feet.
I've got something I can use, if we need to fight.
Are you going to maybe equip it?
Oh-ho!
Hard to use if you don't. Take it out of your bag and put it on your back. It'll be easier to get to if you need it.
God, where would we be without Sarah, man? God, she's helpful. What do I have here? Can I slap her with the herring? That would be pretty cool.
I'm ready. Shall we go?
No time like the present. There must be a path somewhere that leads inland.
Yes, let's if only I could turn around and look at the pathway behind you!
In the trees. Get ready. Draw your weapon.
Oh, so she's not even going to move if something attacks her. Okay. Gonna whack her with that stick. You know what? I'm not gonna listen to her. Screw the path. I'm gonna go see what else I can find on this beach. Maybe there's more coins. Is that a little muscle? Yeah. Use a little muscle. Grog. Rum. I think I'll be staying on this beach for quite a while. Find some palm fronds. I could open up a little tiki bar right here. And if I need somebody to stand around, I know the perfect person for that job. Okay, it autosaves, so I guess I'm about to get into some trouble. Whatever happens to you in real life, you're about to go into a situation and you see the words autosave above your head. If that ever happens, you should really get nervous. Okay, so there's probably some sophisticated timing thing with the parries and the blocks and the dodges. Left, right, A, B, A, B, up, down, and so on. But I think I'll just whack stuff with my stick for a while. That's what I do. Here's another one. I love the way the feathers kind of spray out of the sky as you whack them. That's pretty cool. Okay. Got a little something there. A little fried chicken later on. Looking forward to that. Okay. I don't think this is the path. It is a path. But one thing you'll find very early in this game is you can die very quickly and very suddenly. So, it pays to be careful and to save every 2 seconds. Get some more coins. I'd say you'd miss out on a lot if you just went straight for that path. I like a game like this where there's all kinds of secret little nooks and crannies and you can find all sorts of hidden areas. Let's see, what is this? So there's another drowned person there. Oh, I got a hunting knife. That'll be useful if I decide to gut animals later. Well, this game kind of has an interesting leveling system. You level up automatically, but you have to find trainers to get increases in your stats and your skills. There's pretty cool skills in here, too. I'll tell you that my favorite thing about this game so far, though, is the music. It's not playing now, but if it were playing now, you would be like, wow, that's really good music. Here's another hungry sea vulture. Let's try the knife. Now, I don't have a shield yet. Once you get the shield, you can do a lot better job blocking their attacks. But even with this knife, looks like I could dodge those sea vultures. And what do we have there? I do believe it is a young sting rat. Oh, God. Oh, please don't let me get killed by this young sting rat. That would be... that would be embarrassing.
It must have been attracted by the smell of the bodies. At least we have some meat now. Need a fire or a stove. If I have to eat rat, I'm not eating it raw.
And what's wrong with rat?
Fried meat will help restore our energy, even if it is just rat. We could really do
anti-rat.
Perhaps there's some that grow around here. Keep a lookout.
God, I need some herb to deal with her attitude.
Now, even if it's just a rat.
I'll be glad to get rat. Druid's hemlock. You know, Druid's hemlock, that I'm gonna eat that. Maximum life energy plus one. Well, that's like a permanent boost, I guess. Well, that just goes to show you, folks, whenever you find a weird mushroom in the woods, just go ahead and chow down on that thing. What could possibly go wrong? Oh, there's a hungry wolf. Starting to notice a theme here. Everything is hungry. And the rats are all spiny. Muscle. What is this? Yeah, you can really pick up a lot of stuff. Now, as far as I can tell, there's no key you can hold down to highlight the...
Do you see those torches? Oh, there must be people nearby. Do you think we should head to where the torches are?
No. Man on a plant. I want to stick around and pick up all these herbs. Man, you can't go 2 feet without picking up an herb. What do we have up there? What is that? Another wolf. Now, these guys do a little dodge. You see that little dodge they did? I can dodge too if I had better coordination, but unfortunately, I'm more of a grog guy, less of a coordinated guy. Let's see, let me. regenerate some health. Let's see. I don't think I can eat the raw stuff.
Yes.
Oh. Okay. I got a pearl. Anything in this cave? Oh, that's pretty cool. Coin.
This cave seems a little eerie. Let's find a different way, please. This doesn't feel right.
Oh, God, what is she, Deanna Troi? Gold coin. Skeleton. Healing herb.
Wish I knew about prospecting.
Wish I knew about prospecting. Yes. Apparently I have to get a skill before I can take that iron ore out. Probably need a tool as well. My guess would be a pickaxe, but I wish I knew about prospecting. Oh, more coins? Man. What is this, like Couch Island or something? Man, more. I'm gonna get rich just picking up coins. Alright. Oh, I see another young sting rat. It's time for some rat ass kicking time. Let's see how you like this hunter's knife. Alright, that did not just happen. Note to self, go back and edit this part out so I don't look like a complete dumbass. Hope I don't forget to edit that out later. Okay, enough of that. Now I will demonstrate my rat slaying ability, my true self, my well-prepared self. Not underestimating this young sting rat anymore. He's obviously a ninja. Let's see, sword fighting. 3 attack blows, attack parries, combinations, yep. Okay, yep, Sarah's still alive. That's good to know. Alright. Okay, try the parry. Parry, come on. Parry. There we go. There we go. That's what I'm... Did that little thing laugh at me? Oh, no. No. Yeah, you load. Yeah. I'm not gonna sneak around a young sting rat. Alright, this time I'm out for blood. Yeah, what do I got here? Mana plant, healing plant, yeah, go ahead. Healing root, yeah, go for that. Alright, now let me face this young sting rat for the first time. Okay. You gotta be sort of slick with it. Kill it! God. Man, that young sting rat? I say ID that son of a bitch. He's got to be at least 18. All right. I think we're good. No young sting rats left. Woo, man. This game doesn't play around, man.
Look, it's a house. Looks abandoned. Oh. I wonder what happened here.
Something must have driven the occupants away.
Yeah, like a young sting rat that's actually 40.
Let's take a look around. We might find something useful.
You have a look inside, and I'll keep a watch out here.
I'll keep a watch out here!
Oh, thank you, Sarah.
I'll need a frying pan.
Raw meat. Yeah, raw meat. That's definitely safe.
Now, who could teach me to pick locks?
Okay, I guess I need a lock pick and a skill. I'm not sure if you can bash that thing open somehow. Looks like there's a key there. Yeah, level up. Now, like I was saying, though, you have to find a trainer if you want to do anything. Leveling up gives you these learning points, but you have to spend those with a copious amount of gold. A little trick I learned is if you sleep, you'll heal up automatically. Save your food and your potions for when you really need them. A little mint. Looks like I can't get that torch. Water barrels are another way to heal up, but there's a pretty long animation that goes with that. It only heals you up a little bit, so not ideal. Much better just to find the bed. Let's see. Yep. The key goes to the chest, and I now have frying pan. Quest success. Now I should be able to fry up that hungry sea vulture.
fried meat. I guess these guys haven't invented putting meat on a stick. Gonna have the frying pan.
Smells good.
Okay, what else do I have here? A couple of drumsticks. Mmm. Vulture? Rat? Or herring? Fortunately, I don't think this food gives you any buffs.
I think that's cooked.
Just a little healing remedy.
Doesn't look like there's been anyone in this house for a while. All I found was a locked chest.
Unless you have the key or a talent for picking locks, it's going to stay locked.
Why, thank you.
I've opened the chest.
Find anything useful?
Just a frying pan.
Which I'm
Everything
going to
else
hit you
is
with.
Junk.
Oh well, at least you can fry up that meat. I could do with a little fried meat right
oh,
now.
Oh, how about you
You're
fry it yourself?
Something too, and we can pretend it's venison.
And I can pretend like you're not a...
Here's your fried meat.
At least if you don't think about where it came from. Hey, that's not bad.
We should head further inland.
You go on. I really need to rest. That storm took it out of me. I feel exhausted.
Aww.
I'm going to stay here for a while.
Yes, all that standing around doing nothing is so exhausting.
Okay. I'll come back and get you when I know a bit more about this place.
Don't worry about me. Be careful out there. I saw a path to the north. Looks like it led further inland. Maybe there's a village or something up there.
Sarah, any time is a good time for goodbye. No. Well, apparently this is chapter one now. I don't know what I was in before. Chapter zero. Some berries. There's a magic mushroom. You know, there's, just like in the Gothic series, there's plenty of drugs in this game. We will be smoking the reefer here very soon. Just a heads up. Well, there's Hungry Sea Vulture. These guys are pretty damn easy compared to those rats. Oh. Damn. Just me or these things getting smarter, man. It's like dodging back out of range of my swing blade. Some folks call it a hunter's blade. I call it the swing blade. Alright, there's the mana mushroom. Man, I'm having tons of fun so far, man. This is, if you're into picking mushrooms, I got a game for you. Alright, here we go. Another hungry sea vulture. These guys are all over the place. Look at the size of that thing, too, you know? Look how big those legs are. What a tiny little... How do you get just a regular-sized chicken drumstick out of an ostrich? Let's see. Can I open that? Oh, it's just a tease! It's decorative. Gotta check your inventory. Make sure you don't have any of those herbs that actually give you a permanent boost. Okay. Looks like we're coming up on those ruins, or some of the ruins, from the intro. This is a grave moth. Sorry, grave moth, I wouldn't bother you, but you happen to be standing next to an herb. I notice there's a little something up there on a ledge, too. What is that? Come on, you can do it. Okay, check it out, there's a shield. Well, I didn't see that the first time.
Another grave.
Okay, now we're talking. The shield, you can block almost anything. That's gonna come in real handy. And a little green leaf. This place is like an overgrown salad bar. Go ahead and put this on the quick bar. If you put it on the quick bar, then you can kind of munch as you're running along and just kind of snack on some drumsticks. All right, this looks suitably creepy. Okay. Grave moth in the dark.
Yes.
Easy enough. You can see the lever. It looks like there's a couple of chests here, too, so... Not bad. Almost Kind of feeling like a Tomb Raider game at this point. Should have put in some Zelda-esque musical flourishes when you open up these things. Much better. In the first playthrough, I went with the sword specialization. Pumped up my strength and sword play. Doing pretty well with that. I think for this guy, I'm going to explore the mage option. And try going with the other faction. More on that in a minute. Just looking around, there's probably some secret buttons or something in there, but just leave that for the time being. Oh, mushrooms. Mushrooms, man, these guys are crazy about mushrooms. He's got more mushrooms than a Mario game. Alright, let's get out of here. We gotta be careful not to fall in that pit again. I think they did a pretty good job with that tomb, though. I mean, really nice graphics in there. Oh, I dropped my torch. Okay. Guess that's gone. Alright. Well, let's get back on task. Ah, another sting rat. Let's try the shield this time. Yep, so you can't get around that shield. Yeah. Might have to go back and exact a little vengeance now. Mana plants. Berries. I know this must be some of the most thrilling in-game footage you guys have ever seen. Let's see, got some more grave moths down there. I think I'll just bypass that. And we've got another house. This one looks a little less abandoned. A bench.
Hey, you there. What are you doing here?
Just collecting mushrooms. That's about it, really.
The boat I was on sank. I landed on the beach.
So one of the crew survived the storms, eh? We'd heard it was just the Inquisitor. You don't look like you're with the Inquisition.
I was a stowaway.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition!
You're lucky they didn't catch you and throw you overboard. Or worse, turn you into one of them. Someone or something is looking out for you. And I ain't gonna mess with that. But don't stretch your luck. The White Robes catch you here, you'll be in trouble. If you want my advice, then find yourself a good weapon. You won't get far without one. There may be something around here. Have a look. Come back to me when you found something.
Ooh, I get to search another abandoned hut. Let's look in the cupboard. And white robes. Does that sound ominous to you? I guess a vision of, like, an image of a bunch of guys in white bathrobes coming at you is kind of frightening. This little small healing potion. Man, what's with the fish on the fish trophy? What is that? Some more raw meat? Another bench, chair. I don't know why they bothered to put all this kind of stuff in the game. Okay, what have I got there? A swad. A small map of the island. And that's going to come in really handy. Let me show you this map there. So that actually will tie into the interface. Be a lot easier to get around with that. Some more rum. I found her some rum, a sword. Not any munchies around there. Who ate all the munchies? Oh.
I found this sword.
Good. I hope you know how to use it.
What can you tell me about this place?
What do you want to know?
Why is it always 420 here? Let's see. I can't even see that one option. It sort of cuts off. Some food or pick.
I could do with some help before I go. I'm injured.
So you are. There's a water barrel in the corner. Take a good drink and freshen up. You stink of seawater. If you're planning on getting hurt again, you should get your hands on a few healing potions.
Where can I find some?
Well, they don't grow on trees. You'll have to find a trader for those. There are a few traders still around.
Looks like I'm going to be stuck here for a while. Anywhere I can get some food or pick up some gold?
Ha! Not round here, at any rate.
Has he looked on the ground?
I just asked for this post so I can watch the storms. Amazing things when they blow past. Strange how they never come inland. A few weeks ago, I would have sent you to Harbour Town, but not anymore.
Why not?
It's full of Inquisition. protecting those ruins and recruiting for the damn White Robe cult at the monastery. I'm with the Don myself. We're the only ones who are still free. Living in a camp in the middle of a swamp. But freedom's freedom. I'd head to the swamp. See if the Don will take you in. Or try your luck in Harbour Town. Just stay away from the monastery.
I think just to be a jerk, I'm going to go straight to the monastery this time.
So is Harbour Town safe? What are the Inquisition doing there?
Not much at the moment. There are still some of our boys in there. They might help you out. And that White Robe lot probably won't bother you too much. I can show you the way, but believe me, you'd be better off at our camp.
Just look for the plume.
You mentioned a monastery. What happens there?
The last place you want to be. It's where the Inquisition train their recruits. Brainwash them. Stay well away from there.
There's a girl came ashore with me. She's in an abandoned house to the south.
South? Must be the old shipwrecker's house. I'll head that way later, if she's there.
I'm pretty sure she's still there. Just standing there.
What's the Don got to offer me?
Meat? Beer? A job? He might even train you as a fighter.
You had me
a
beer.
You've got a sword, after all. Most they'll let you have up at the monastery is a staff. Just a big stick. That's not a real weapon.
Now a banana! That's a weapon.
Can you show me the way to Harbour Town?
Sure. Follow me.
Okay.
See that farm down in the valley?
I see it.
Some of the Inquisition's minions work down there. Novices, they call them. They're apprentices to the mages in the monastery. Talk to them. They'll help you get to Harbour Town. But watch you don't find yourself accidentally recruited. You get recruited, there'll be no welcome for you at the Don's camp.
Thanks. I can take it from here.
I'm sure you can. Good luck. See you around.
Alright, gotta move on. Not a whole lot of stuff in this journal yet, but eventually that will have all kinds of useful information, logs of my dialogues, has a quest map that'll show you the locations of the people that are relevant for your current quest. But one thing they don't have in this game is giant gold question marks and exclamation points over people's heads, which I kinda like.
Are you crazy walking around here? What do you think will happen if the Inquisition catch you, eh?
Who's in charge here?
Brother Tristan. You can usually find him in front of the farmhouse. He's taken the farm over. He runs the place now.
I see. Are you going to call them?
Hey, I won't give you away. But the warriors of the Order often come by here to check on things. So I'm just saying, you better be careful.
What do you do here?
I'm working in my field.
Your field?
Yeah. This one's mine and the other one on the other side of the path is Teller's. Of course, he's further along working his one. Always is. Don't know how he does it. He's already taken his whole harvest to the storehouse. But I'm afraid I won't be able to get my harvest in on time. I can't spot the ripe plants from the unripe. They all look the same to me.
You need help?
You serious? Well, I wouldn't say no.
And what kind of compensation would not saying no come with?
Well, I'm only a novice, so I don't have much. But if you harvest the plants and bring them to me, I'll give you a healing potion. How about that?
Deal. I'll bring you those ripe plants.
Great. Then I might actually be able to start my mage training before this place goes completely to the dogs. Just look out for the ripe ones in my field, all right? 10 should be enough. Bring them back here, all right?
And here goes another epic quest. Now, normally I would skip over something like this, but I'm finally hearing some of that music that I was telling you about, so I just want to crank that up so you can enjoy that for a little while.
Here are your 10 ripe plants.
Thanks. Without you, I would have been in a whole world of trouble. The
healing... Well, that music was composed, by the way, by one Kai Rosenkrantz. Apparently he's done the same guy that did the music for the Gothic series. Looks like that's all he's done here is Gothic and the Risen games. Anyway, I really, really like the music in this. I might see if I can find an original soundtrack to download and just enjoy that on its own. Consistently good music. Okay, I'm going to skip ahead a little bit here. As you can see, the game has a bit of a long wind-up before anything really gets going. So I'll skip forward until I get to Harbor Town.
Part of the town guard.
That's right. I'm guarding the gate so no one can leave.
Shouldn't you stand inside then?
And not really much of a surprise. It's not going to be as easy as walking into the gate. They actually have done a pretty good job in this game with these different factions and political alliances and muddying the water as to which faction is good and which one is bad. They all seem to have positive and negative points. Always kind of enjoy that in a game. And this game definitely delivers on that front. So basically what's going on here, there's this guy called the Don that's basically this outlaw leader in the swamp, and the other side, I guess, is the Order and the Inquisition or whatever, and they're both after all these artifacts that are popping up inside these mysterious ruins that are coming out of the ground, as you saw in the intro. And it's fairly complex, the relationship between these factions, and the mages are seem to be kind of in the middle of all of this. So there's a lot of political intrigue, a lot of interesting ethical decisions to make. I think they did a really good job on the story and these factions.
What about our little deal?
Otherwise, we'll both wind up in the monastery.
Are you going to let me in?
Well, you want to go in uninformed, that's up to you. But here, at least take a town map. Good luck. You'll need it.
And there we go, now we're in Harbor Town. So the other route you could take is to go to the swamp and join the outlaw band right away. I haven't decided which approach I like better. It seems like you'll see both areas eventually no matter what, but it definitely has some replay value. I mean, it's a totally different experience playing with this faction than it was in my other game.
Out!
You have to be careful about stealing things and hanging out where
Just
you don't
leave,
belong.
Will you?
If you make these guys mad, there are ways to calm them back down, but you're probably better off just avoiding that. It does have an option to become a thief and have stealth mode. You can pickpocket people. But I think for the time being, I'll just try to stay on the right side of the law.
Spare a coin for a poor farmer. We have nothing to eat. My wife Martha is sick.
Here, 25 gold pieces.
Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Good luck, and don't give up hope.
I won't. Thank you.
Can I help you?
Are you a healer? My wife is so sick, I fear the worst.
What's wrong with her?
She's feverish. I blame these cursed bloody ruins.
Why? How did they make her ill?
They came out of the ground right next to my damn farm. Next day, Martha caught this fever. And she's got sicker since then. I don't know what to do. Her only hope is Master Belshaw.
Who is Master Belshaw?
A mage from the monastery. He spends his time at the Shrine of the Flame, back in the gutters. He cares about poor farmers like us. No one else does.
I really want to become a mage with this guy, so as far as I can tell, the healer he's talking about is the way to that path, so I'm going to try to work with him.
You're new here, right? Leto let you in, huh?
Well, so we finally made it to Harbor Town. It's a pretty nice town, too. I love the way this is laid out here. Lots of interesting characters about.
Hey, wait a minute. Don't walk by. Try the best fish in town. This is your lucky day, because I have one perfect piscine offer for you.
You do.
Buy one fish and get a second fish completely free. Two fish for the price of one.
Sounds like a good deal.
A perfect piscine offer. Okay, so here's the guy that I believe will help me become a mage.
May the holy flame light your way, stranger. Are you looking for a spot of warm fire? Or some stew to salve your hunger?
You're a mage.
I am that. I am Master Belshaw, a guardian of the Holy Flame, ordained into the Convocation of Mages.
What can you do with magic?
It has many uses. There are spells which harm and spells which heal, and those that light your path in the darkness. With no study at all, you could cast from a scroll, though scrolls can be used but once. Whereas an artifact with magic bound into it can last an age. But to create such items, or use magic without the need of them, for that you must become a mage.
I'm guessing this isn't a straightforward process.
What is it you do in the town?
I help those who are unable to help themselves. For now, that means providing food, shelter, other necessities. Why don't you help me?
What can I do for you?
Help me to care for the people. There are those who are sick and injured. They are in need of healing potions.
How can I become a mage?
You need a firm will and much patience to be chosen. As a mage, you would bear great responsibility. Are you fit for such a role?
Yes.
A quick answer. That speaks for self-confidence. But dedication, not speed, is required for study. If you can show dedication to the Holy Flame, then I would see you as more fit for training.
Right. I can distribute those healing potions for you.
Good, good. Thank you. I have 7 potions prepared. I will give you a list with the names of the needy here in the gutters. Consider the remaining potions payment for your work.
I could use some stew.
Here, may it grant you strength.
Well, it's not rad, but it's okay.
Thank you. What is the Holy Flame?
In the monastery at the foot of the volcano, there's a holy place. It's one of the last true treasures of this world. The Hall of the Holy Flame. It's the source of our power, a well of magic. We must do all we can to protect it from the looming danger.
See, I'm guessing the base of a volcano is probably not the best place to build a monastery, but... See, now that I have the town map, I should be able to see where these guys are. Yeah, there we are. So, much better. Shouldn't be hard at all to track these guys down and get this quest done. But let's skip forward a bit again. I want to show you some of the more exciting parts of the game.
Welcome.
So the first game, I went with the Dawn instead of trying to get into the Inquisition and become a mage. And this is one of the early combats. It's really memorable. You have to work your way up the arena, increasingly difficult opponents, until you get to the leader of the warriors here, the guards, Brogar. Extremely tough fight. He's really quick, got a lot of moves, and if he just gets a couple licks on you, you're toast. You don't have very good armor or weapons at this point, of course. And I found the trick to this was just to be patient, wait for the openings, and just be very careful with keep your guard up at all times. You can winnow him down slowly, but one wrong move and you have to start over. Now there's a little trick if you can, instead of holding your shield up, if you put it up just right when he's about to attack, you can do a parry. And that stuns him a little while and you get a couple of moves in. The only danger is if you don't time it just right, he'll get a hit on you. You can also try to dodge by double tapping to the left or right, or I guess back, but again, the timing is very precise to get that right, and you can make yourself vulnerable. You'll see a couple times here. See, there I went, got behind him, got a swing in. You know, as you probably know, I'm more of a turn-based combat guy, but as far as arcade-style combat goes, this game probably has the best engine I've played to date. Feels really tight with these controls. I never felt like it was... You know, when I lost a combat, I felt like it was my fault. Didn't feel like it was loose controls or a shoddy AI or anything like that, or bad collision detection. And also like how when you level up your sword ability, you get new moves. So about the time you get pretty used to a certain combo, if you level up your sword play, you can actually learn some new moves. So it stays fresh that way. So all in all, I really enjoyed the combat. Even though this is a single-player game, there are battles where you have allies with you, leading attack here on these ruins that are protected by the white robes. And I got the warriors from the the Dawn's warriors to help me out here. Even with their help, this will be a nightmarish battle. These warriors of the Order, again, they get a couple hits on you, you're down. Maybe you can quaff a potion. Maybe they'll just finish the job as you're trying to quaff that potion. So you really have to be on your toes with this. I found it's better just to wait until they're distracted fighting the other guys and then you know, come up behind them and nail them. See, I just got hit right there. I mean, these combats can just turn on a dime. You're doing well, next thing you know, you're dead. Okay, those two are down. You can see they picked up a third guy there. Looks like he's pretty well surrounded. Maybe I can swoop in and finish him off. There you go. So you can see that's three of 11 done. Go ahead and grab the loot here. I don't think there's any weight restriction on the loot. At least I never encountered one. Which is quite kind of nice because I like to get all the loot. Hate leaving stuff on the ground. Even though that probably is more realistic. Just don't find it more fun. Go ahead and quaff that. Eat that sausage there. Always good to eat some sausage before a big workout. Okay, I know there's some more of these guys up here. I don't even think I fought their boss yet. Yeah, see, there's their boss over there. Now, if I can slip up, get his attention somehow. Unfortunately, I had to sell my bow to afford this mace. Rudolph. All right. One sucky thing, though, you notice he's got armor on. I don't get his armor after the battle. But I can get his staff there if I wanted. All the different weapons have their own skills to level up. Swords, axes. I think that's probably a staff. And what's the other one? Oh, crossbows and bows. Got him backed up into the woods there, but I don't trust it. I can't see him. I don't want him to one-shot me. There we go. Okay, I think we're going to get him this time. Looks like he's got a little bit of health. Got him. Okay. Now, it should be... Okay, I must have accidentally clicked on him. Should be just about done there. I think there might be a few more of these recruits left to fight. And loot the corpses. Okay, where are they? There's four. I don't know if I can take four on at once.
Don't do that.
Yeah, it looks like I got three. Okay, good. Good old CRPG mechanic. Oh, nope, fourth one's coming. Okay. Well, this will be interesting. Oh, I don't want to be there. Get back. Get back. Whoa, what the hell just happened to him? Okay, he's out. Looks like we got rid of the bad ones. These recruits are... Oh, whoa. Now that was a proper whack with a mace. Alright, so that's looking pretty good. Got the camp cleaned out.
I got rid of the white robes that were in the southeast.
You've come to exactly the right person. I'm exactly the person that needed to know that. Go to Fincher or the Don, you ass.
Yeah, I was wondering why I was telling him. You know, he did just participate in the combat. So there you have it, folks. I think that's enough to give you a little flavor of Risen. Quite a lot to do. I didn't even get into the skill system. It's got cooking, alchemy, blacksmithing, lots of stuff you can do as a hunter, gutting animals, and even chipping out their teeth and claws to sell to merchants, just to name a few things. And I like it's got just enough sort of faction politics to keep it interesting without just becoming bewildering or just feeling like you're just overwhelmed with options. You know, it maintains a pretty tight focus throughout. And I was able to follow the story pretty well. And it's also got nice replay value because, you know, if you choose a different faction, a different class, you know, it's almost like a totally different experience. So I'll commend them for that. And as I mentioned before, probably my favorite part of this game was the music. Just lovely music throughout. Anytime it would play, I would crank up the volume and just really enjoy it. Really sets the tone. The graphics are pretty good. I got it scaled down here to 720. I was playing it on 4K, actually. Looks really good. But all in all, I really like this game. I intend to finish it. I think I'm probably about 10 hours in and feel like I've just started to scratch the surface. Just about to head to the volcano in my main game. So anyway, I'll leave it there. Let me know your thoughts on this game. Also, I'm kind of curious what you think about the sequels. One of them just came out a couple years ago, I think. And I noticed some of the reviews of those people were complaining that the combat in this game, I guess, seems simplistic compared to some of the options in the later ones. You know, I haven't played those, so I don't really have anything to compare it to. Like I said, I like the combat in this one. I don't know if I would necessarily want it to be more complex than it is. I also read that if you do the archery combat, it's easier to play. I worked a little bit with bows, but you know, usually I'm not much of a archery kind of guy when I play these games. I want to be in there with a sword or an axe. Yeah, it just feels more intimate, if you will. I think it's safe to say if you like the Gothic series, I don't know why you wouldn't want to play this. Otherwise, if you're looking for something with a lot of fast-paced combat, but also something that doesn't skimp on the dialogue and storyline, it's a large world, but it doesn't feel just so immense that they've resorted to a lot of procedurally generated stuff. You know, this actually feels like a coherent place, a game you could conceivably finish without having to dedicate your life to it, if you know what I mean. So all in all, I'm really impressed with Risen. I'm going to attempt to finish this first one, and then maybe move on to the sequel. We'll see how it goes, but see if it maintains the momentum. It's kind of been slowly building up to the point where, in my main game, it was hard to stop to make this video, because I just wanted to get to that volcano place and see what that was all about. So it's got its hooks into me, which is always a great sign. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and as always, let me know your thoughts on the game as well as the review itself. And I'll see you next week. That's all for this week's episode. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Should be back next week. Not quite sure what to expect yet. I've got a couple of interviews that seem to be lining up. Or it could be another retrospective. So some of you guys have already made some suggestions for me for that. Both guests you'd like to see, as well as games you'd like to see. But please keep those coming. I definitely will consider whatever you guys want to see on the channel. As always, I want to thank you very much for your support of the show. Really means a lot to me, guys. As you probably know, we lost an executive producer of the show a couple weeks ago. So if you're one of those guys that's been watching regularly, trying to decide, you know, when's that right time to go ahead and pledge, please just go ahead and do that. All I ask is $1 a show. Really means a lot to me, is keeping these episodes coming. So thank you very much to everyone who has supported the show. And hopefully, if you're not part of that, that body, you will soon. In which case, you'll get access to things like that Google Air Hangout we just had a couple days ago. Lots of fun. And those are, anybody can watch those, but if you're a Patreon supporter, you can actually join in and chat via text or even be in the video. So thank you, everybody. Now what about that news from the Matt Cave? Oh man, quite a bit of news this week. Let's see. First of all, Sebastian Frank wrote in about his game, The Beer Hall Putsch. The Putsch. Putsch. I'm never sure how to say that name. Anyway, the Hitler thing. It's a point-and-click adventure game. It looks like a pretty interesting take. I don't want to, you know, I'll let you watch the video if you want to learn more about the background of this, but it looks pretty interesting, especially for fans of the old Sierra or LucasArts style point-and-click adventure games. It's on Indiegogo. They're trying to raise, I believe, 30,000 euros, which I believe is something like 2 million US dollars. Just kidding about that. I don't actually have any clue what that amounts to. But they're up to 2,000, and they got something like 70 days left. So anyway, there's a free demo available. If you like point and clicks, go check it out. Download the demo. If it looks like something you want to support, then go ahead and spring for it. I personally like the historical angle. And that's a very interesting bit of history, by the way, this whole... If you don't know what the Beer Hall Putsch is, go check out the video for sure. Let's see what else we have here. Hero Song. Remember, I think I actually had been sort of announcing that last week, John Smedley's project. That's already been canceled, if you can believe that. Apparently, they just didn't think they had raised enough money fast enough. They thought it was
going to end badly, I suppose. So they went ahead and folded rather than suffer the indignity, I guess, of getting further along. So I don't really know what's up with that. It looked like a pretty promising project to me. But anyway, that's too bad. In other news, if you like sensible soccer, remember I had John Hare on several years ago, really great guy. Apparently there is something called the Soccer or Sensible World of Soccer Championships. Had no idea these existed, but this is the 13th annual such championship. It's going to be held in Almelo, something like that, in the Netherlands on August 20th. And August 21st, which, by the way, August 20th is my birthday. So that'd be pretty cool if somehow or another for my birthday I got to go to the Sensible World of Soccer Championships in the Netherlands. You know, I got some friends that live there. And I've never been anywhere, but I think the only other country I've been to is Colombia. So that'd be pretty cool to get to see the Netherlands. Plus, I like the Sensible Software guys. Okay, what else we have here? Revolution, remember those, the Broken Sword, Beneath a Still Sky. They have released about to release a 25th anniversary box set with all of their classic games, as well the Broken Sword series is in there. I don't have all the details for this, but I'm definitely going to keep my eye on that. I'll let you know more as I learn more. And by the way, that Sensible World of Soccer and the Revolution, those are both from the Retro Feed, which I'll post a link to those guys. Retro, I think, I don't know the whole name, like Retro Gamer or something like that. But anyway, I'll go ahead and post a link to their blog too, so that's where I get a lot of these news segments. All right, what about that ale of the week? Well, this is going to round out my ginger beer, ginger ale series here. This is the last one I've been able to find locally. This is the Blue Sky Jamaican ginger ale. It's got a big sticker on here, made with real sugar, which I always like to see. Not a big fan of the artificial sweeteners. I hate that stevia, NutraSweet, whatever. Just, I don't want it. Don't like the taste of it. But this has real sugar, so that's cool. Nothing else here really to see. I was wondering where these guys are from. Apparently no caffeine, no high fructose corn syrup. If you're concerned about that, where are these guys based? Let's see. Corona, California. Blue Sky Natural Beverage Company. So I assume these are pretty widely distributed. You might be able to find one of these locally. Anyway, let's get this open and see what it's all about. All right, so I got some of this Blue Sky Jamaican ginger ale. And I was just thinking about this. Is there a difference between ginger ale and ginger beer? I have no idea. I probably should have looked that up. But anyway, I know some of you guys would probably know the answer to that. So if you do, please chime in the comments. I'm just curious. I have no idea. Well, this one, it smells really good. You definitely smell the ginger in this. Some kind of other herb in there. I'm not exactly sure what makes it Jamaican ginger ale. Maybe a little bit of jerk seasoning, maybe, or some kind of plantain. Anyway, it just smells really, really good. I mean, I don't know who could smell this and not want to at least try it, so let's give it a taste. Let me give it a second there. A very strong taste on this. A lot of citrus flavor, a little bit of ginger, but a lot of some kind of all sort of a vaguely medicinal like flavor, kind of a licorice like it does you know, kind of taste a little bit like some jerk seasoning, if you had like Jamaican jerk chicken or something. That's what it kind of reminds me of. I have no idea what kind of herb that is. To me it tastes slightly medicinal. Maybe somebody else would enjoy that flavor. I'll try it again here. So yeah, it's kind of got this sort of a strange aftertaste, like there's a lot of herbal stuff going on there. Let's see, does it tell you what the ingredients are? No artificial flavors. It just says natural ginger flavor, citric acid, and caramel color. There's definitely something in here besides just ginger flavor, though. I guess it's just kind of a mystery. But anyway, I'm not going to say I really like this too much. It's kind of like if you had, say, a Mountain Dew and you mixed in, say, a little bit of orange-flavored Alka-Seltzer. What it kind of tastes like to me. It's not terrible, but I think I like the other ones I've tried a lot more than that. I'm going to go 2 out of 5 drinking horns on this one. If you want a ginger ale with a kind of exotic medicinal-like flavor to it, go ahead and go for this one, the Blue Sky Jamaican Ginger Ale. But I think there's some better ginger ales out there. I'm not a real big fan of that Jamaican flavor, whatever that means. So I'll go with, 2 out of 5 drinking horns on the Jamaican Ginger Ale from Blue Sky. All right, let's wrap this up with a quotation. And I was looking for quotations about swords, and I found a really, really good one from Confucius. It goes something like this. Never give a sword to a man who can't dance. See you guys next week.
Don't play games with me!